when I search for Nebuchadnezzar on Google Images, they show Saddam Hussein. And I mean, that's the kind of thinking people, wow, you think about Gaddafi, Saddam Hussein, wow, these kind of people who kill lots of people, hey, yo, deserve to die. That's the way human beings think. Nebuchadnezzar is far worse. He's an absolute despot. He's an absolute tyrant. Remember in chapter 2, when the advisors, astrologers, magicians came and couldn't give him an answer, what did he say to them? You can't give me an answer? I'll tear you limb by limb. Do you know how patient God is with Nebuchadnezzar? For a course of some 30 years, 25, 30 years, God never gave up on him. God sent Daniel into his palace. God gave him the dream of the statue to warn him. God gave him the dream of the trees to warn him. And when he still wouldn't listen, God made him like an animal. And this is not out of cruelty, it is out of compassion. So that Nebuchadnezzar will learn. C.S. Lewis says, God whispers to us in our pleasures, speaks in our consciences, but shouts in our pains. It is his megaphone to rouse a deaf world. And God is shouting to Nebuchadnezzar, wake up! You are not God! Don't destroy your life! I'm reaching out to you through your pains.